I got a package today, as the title says above. Hey guys, I'm here with a new review. You may be wondering, unless you have been watching Signor Fini, whatever did I get in that package that I didn't show on camera? And I was going to mail to a friend. Well, here you go. This is a blast from the past, because you are seeing this about 2 months in the future of my time. And by the time you're seeing this, Feeny's probably gotten it by now. He's probably already reviewed it. And I think it's time for me to review it. Why am I reviewing it now? Well, I figured I will never ever get these figures again. I do find them interesting, but not enough for me to buy them for myself. So, we're going to have a review of Beast Wars Microverse. Orcanoch and Arachnid. I think that's Orcanoch, because it's an orca, and then they added an ock, so Orcanoch, maybe that's Orcanoch. Orcanoch, I don't know. Orcan of time, I don't know. Anyway, I have a cold, so you may hear me going a lot, which I apologize. So I'm going to scoot him aside. Here we have Orcanoch. He is a killer whale, and he looks pretty cool, I gotta say. Quick background. I don't have this guy. I don't care enough to look him up. That's not what I do around here. I've never actually heard of this guy until Feeny mentioned him in a thread on the Optobotomist Show forums. Mentioned how this is like, you know, one of his dream figures to get. Never heard of it. Looked it up and I was like, well, that's kind of stupid. And I found an auction. I showed him and he was like, oh, I want it. But guy didn't ship to Canada. So I helped out. And, you know, he's actually grown on me quite a bit. This is an interesting little figure. And I don't know. I really do like it. I transform this guy. I'm going to start off. Pull out the escape pod. Right here. Set aside. Now, I'm not going to fire this because I don't want to risk losing anything. But there's a little button where you can fire the front like it's a missile. It comes off and reveals the cockpit of the submarine right there. And that can hold one of the minifigures included. But that aside, like I said, I don't want to risk losing anything, so I'm going to do this nice and slow. I'm not going to fire any missiles, not going to do anything that could lose a piece, and then I would feel horrible. Then, what I do at least, rotate this around, rotate that down, separate the tail fin into its four sections, and then that's where you may have caught a glimpse of what the instructions call the Energon chip. Basically, we know it as a web thing. Put your finger on it, and it does work, just it takes a while. He's a maximal. He is. See, he's a maximal. Whales are actually mammals. I don't know if you knew that or not, but maximals, mammals. There you go. And you're going to rotate. And you're going to rotate. And then once that's done, pull that out. Pull that out to extend the panels. So now you've got this little action going here. Then you're going to pull that up, rotate it. Then you're going to separate that like that, rotate it. And then after that, just kind of just, you know, you have to put on the accessories and you're done. The accessories start off this little panel here. You're going to pop this out. It becomes a gun. Flip it around. Put it around like that. Go on the other side. Pop it out. Flip it around. Put it in like that. Ooh, look, he's got two guns now. And he also comes with... I forgot where this goes. I looked it up and I completely forgot where this goes. I may have to use the instructions. But he comes with a computer panel right here that I may just mount anywhere just for the time being because I don't remember where anything went. I browsed the instructions before I got this guy out, and sad to say, my memory is completely failing me. But he comes with a little gun here, which you kind of can't see. There you go. And I believe that mounts in the top there. He's got another little gun, or a claw here. You know, focus, there you go. And he goes up here. And if I'm guessing they could also go there, or you could put the monitor there. I don't know, something like that. There's a lot of little places you can put the stuff. I would look it up, but it's a pain to record video and have my internet open. My computer doesn't like it. It panics and it freaks out and it kills a baby. It's not a pleasant experience. I'm not going to do it. But if you want to see a good review, go check out Signor Fini. He's in my subscriptions page, unless he's angered me and I have removed him, which is a possibility these days. Canadians. But there you have him. That's really about it. It's just a little playset. He also comes with Optimus Primal, which it's an interesting little look for him, I gotta say. And an even hotter thing, more odd, Tarantulas minus his legs. And a lot of paint. So pretty much, you know, the gimmicks are you can have Primal riding in the escape pod, which does open. And he will fall out if I try, but you can have him riding in the escape pod. You can fit him in the chair or the cockpit in there. But you get him in. He does fit in there like that pretty nicely. And I think that's really about it. The other thing is Tarantulas. You can stand him on here, and you can either, when you have him standing on this spot, like that, I'm not going to do it because I don't want to risk losing this little guy. You can either flick that up to kind of send him flying, or you can put him in the trap door like that, and he's locked in. That's his little prison. I got to do a lot of that. And, you know, the details on this guy are actually kind of cool. He has the rub sign. You can store his four missiles in this back section here, so when it's transformed, it's all nice and hidden, packed away. He has a caution maximal flight deck. You open the cockpit for the submarine, or the whole playset, really. You've got some sticker details inside of there. And just a little, you know, scan thing there. You know, this one actually did grow me quite a bit. I thought the Microverse playsets were kind of stupid. But this guy does kind of grow me. I was kind of tempted to keep him. But I'm not going to do that. That would be very mean. So there's that. There's Orcanoch. I don't know. But here we have Arachnid. Arachnid, of course, if you cannot tell, is a lizard. Oh, wait. He's a spider. Sorry. There are two versions of this toy. There is this one that has all the yellow, and then there's another one where the yellow pieces are replaced with glow-in-the-dark pieces. And I kind of wondered, you know, how this thing would look if you got one that had a mismatch of pieces where, you know, one was yellow, one was glow-in-the-dark. And you're kind of stuck with a great googly-moogly radioactive spider, like Peter Parker. But here you have Arachnid. He looks like a pretty cool spider. It's not that bad-looking. A lot of kibble in the bottom here. He's not as hidden as the other one. He has a vehicle mode. So, yeah. But anyway, vehicle mode. Flip the little wings forward because we all know webbing is the best wings ever. Rotate the back section. Rotate down these little treads in the side. See like that? You gotta reach it and you gotta rotate them down like that. Uh-oh, almost did a voice there. And then the front, pop that out. And there you have tank or vehicle mode. It's interesting. I don't know. Not sure if I like it or not. It's interesting to say the least, though. But go ahead, transform it. Gonna reach in, plop this whole part back, and it looks like a mini volcano, which I find kind of interesting. Or a anus of some kind. Reach aside, plop this little section out. That's gonna be a little turret. Not turret syndrome, a turret. It's a gun. Grab this part, rotate it. And that's really about it. Now it's time for what? Accessories! Which you guys love when I say, apparently. I don't know why. But it comes with a little claw that you mount onto one of the spider legs. He comes with a little hook that you mount onto the other spider leg. You can get it on there. So it's like this. Then it comes with another little claw that you mount onto the back section here. Or maybe I have it upside down, but little things like that. He also comes with I believe this one was the fly. A fly vehicle that you mount here. Or not mount, but lay there. So it's kind of like a flight deck. And then you have a little spider. A flying thing that goes there. Oh, good lord.
Men of people.
Beast found it, don't worry. And he comes with... Oh, I forgot. I need to take the little piece there and flip it and rotate it around. There you go. His little figures he comes with... This seems kind of like an odd little combination, but you've got Megatron. And then you've got Razor Beast. Now, I don't know why they couldn't just, you know, copy what they did with the Orcanoch set. But they gave him yellow plastic for the legs instead of the gray plastic the other ones had. And an even funnier thing, to me it's funny at least, they used two different looks for the figures. Optimus Primal is more gorilla-ish. Although he may be a bat, because he has kind of these little hawk claws, but he's painted as if it's Primal from the series, okay? He's black instead of blue like the bat. But Megatron is the mold of the alligator figure. Which is interesting. I don't know why this one could easily have been the bat if they had left the top section blue like his head. Or like his back. But maybe the guy, you know, I won this from, painted it. I don't know. I don't think so, because it's really glossy paint. And, oh god, I just dropped Prime.
Hello again. It's just me.
There we go. So, I don't know. I don't know if he was... I don't think he was painted. I think this is how he was originally. But, anyway. Megatron, ape. Megatron, alligator, primal, ape. There you go. So then, of course, you know, the figures can't fit in there like the other ones. You can fit somebody in here. You can fit somebody in there. I'm not going to do it because I've already shown it once. And you can fit them in the little flying vehicles. The turret does rotate all the way around. The claws do move in and out. You know, like he's got to scratch that itch on his nose. The little cage does open for the control center right in there. There's no sticker detailing like with Orcanoch. I'm gonna stop doing that. And then on the inside we got, you know, a little sticker detail. Here is the Energon chip, which is a lot harder to show on camera than the other one because it's way in there. But that's really about it, I do believe. I don't know what these go for normally on eBay. I've never seen them except for this one time, so I don't know if they're rare or not. I really don't know. But, if out of the two, I definitely like this one more. And I forgot to point out something. I mentioned it came with four missiles. Well, much like how the whale head can shoot off here, you would load the missiles in there, push a button, and they would shoot off. And I believe the spider originally had missiles too. I think I saw a picture where they had missiles, but I may be horribly mistaken since I don't see a place where you can load them on. Maybe I just saw the little guns. I don't know. But if you can find these, I would definitely recommend Orcanoch out of the two. I think he's my favorite out of both of them. But Arachnid's interesting, too. It is an interesting little take on Beast Wars. You know, it's not just a Transformer. It's a Transformer into a playset with little figures around just to show you, you know, how they work out in scale. But that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the review. I hope these figures made it to you okay, Signor Fini. If not, then... I don't have them. It's been 2 months. Some guy in Portugal is probably playing with them right now. And that's it, guys. I'm done. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day. See you around.